Hey guys, and a very warm welcome back to my channel. So in the previous video we talked about India-Bangladesh relations, and this is the part 2 of that video in continuation of that video. So we will be talking about the remaining topics in the field of India-Bangladesh relations. So here we are talking about the India-Bangladesh relation, and you are currently at a channel where we will be giving free UPSC lectures, UPSC preparation, where we will be talking about both prelims and mains, and we will be having the discussion about all the topics which are important from your UPSC point of view, from the perspective of pre as well as mains, and we'll be discussing everything starting from GS to CSAT to answer writing. Okay, and you'll be given the comprehensive lectures for all of them. I've already uploaded many videos. If you guys have not seen them yet, just go check them out. So from this video we'll be starting with India-Bangladesh relation, and before we start I would like all of you guys to please go and subscribe to our channel. This course is completely free for all of you, because I just don't believe in paying for a noble thing like education. Okay, so just go and subscribe. This is what I'm asking for you. Just go subscribe, like, share with your friends, so that we'll have a better reach and it will help us motivate to grow more. So now let us start our conversation about India-Bangladesh relations, and this is part 2. I would request all of you to watch part 1 because this is in continuation to that only. So now let us start with our discussion. So first of all, I would like to tell you that in the recent video we have discussed about, we were talking about the water sharing issues, and we have already discussed about the Teesta water sharing issue. In detail we have talked about it. Okay, Teesta water sharing is done. Okay, and we have talked about the Ganga water sharing issue. We have talked about that also. Okay, so in this video we will be talking about the third issue, that is the dam of River Barak. Okay, so dam that has been constructed on River Barak. River Barak. Okay, so this is the dam that has been constructed by India on the River Barak. Okay, so it is also known as this dam of River Barak is also known as Tipai, TIPAI, Tipai Mukh. MUKH, Tipai Mukh Dam. This is the other name for this dam, okay? Tipai Mukh Dam. So this is a dam that has been, this is a proposed dam basically. It has not yet been constructed. This was meant to be constructed but has not been constructed yet. So it was a proposed dam, and the proposal was in around 1984. Okay, the proposal was in around 1984, and this is a proposed dam. Okay, this has not yet been constructed. So what are the issues regarding this dam? So India is proposing that there should be a 1500 megawatt 1500 megawatt project should be there, and there should be a river run project where 1500 megawatt of hydroelectric energy should be produced, okay, with the flood control component. So the basic importance of this dam would be in the construction of the hydroelectric project, HEP, hydroelectric project, plus there should be some kind of flood control also. Okay, flood control would also be practiced through this dam. So this is the two things that we are talking about. Okay, also the Barak River, which is the origination of the river Barak. Barak River is originating from it is originating from Assam. Okay, this river is originating from Assam and it is called Kushiara. It is called as Kushiara in Assam. The name of this river is Kushiara in Assam. Okay, so the Barak in Assam and Kushiara in Bangladesh this river is called as Kushiara and in Assam it is called as river Barak. Okay, so in 2011 Manmohan Singh said that we will construct this dam only if Bangladesh wants. Okay, so it was a decision on Bangladesh that if they wanted to want us to construct this dam or not. Okay, but in 2013 what did Manipur government did in 2013 what Manipur government did was that Manipur government in collaboration with NHPC. So Manipur government in collaboration with NHPC. NHPC means National Hydro Electric Power Corporation. Okay, National Hydro Electric Power Corporation. Okay, so this is the NHPC and another authority, that is Satlej Vidhut. Satlej Vidhut, not Vidhut, Vidhut. Why है यहाँ पे? ठीक है, Vidhut Nigam Limited. Okay, so these three authorities together, Manipur government, NHPC and Satlej Vidhut Nigam, they signed a tri-corporate agreement for the construction of this particular dam, Barak dam. Okay, and this was, of course, this is going to be opposed by the Bangladesh. Okay, and after the opposition that came from Bangladesh, there was no agreement that happened. Okay, so this has been like that only till now. It was a proposed project, but it never happened. Okay, so this was all about the dam on River Barak. Now I would like to talk about certain complaints. So now I would like to talk about certain complaints which were related, which were posed by Bangladesh, why they were objecting this dam. So first of all, there is an issue of less flow. Okay, if a dam would be constructed, so the flow of the river is going to be restricted. Okay, and also India should not take the decisions related to Bangladesh. Okay, Bangladesh said that we are sovereign and we would take our own decision, and India should not take any decision based on the behalf of Bangladesh. Okay, and also there was no kind of environmental study that was done. Okay, there was no environmental study that was done, so we don't know what would be the impact of this dam. Okay, there was no environmental study that was done, so we don't know what would be the impact of this dam. Okay, so these were certain complaints from Bangladesh's side related to River Barak. Now after this dispute, after now we complete this Barak dam dispute, now let us come to the another kind of dispute. We talked about the water sharing dispute. Now we'll talk about the maritime disputes. Okay, so what are the basic maritime disputes between India and Bangladesh? So there was an issue related to exclusive economic zone. Okay, there was an issue there. So there was this issue, and there was an issue related to some exclusive economic zone between India and Bangladesh, and there was an issue related to certain maritime border. Okay, so that was in around 2009. This issue was there. This issue began. Okay, and this matter was then taken to Court of Arbitration, which we talked about only, which is in Hague. Okay, this matter was taken to them, and the verdict was more or less in favor of by and large favor of Bangladesh. And the verdict was verdict came in around 2014. The verdict came, and the disputed area, which was around 25,600 square kilometer of disputed area, was there. Okay, so verdict came on this area. Out of this 25,600 square kilometer, permanent court of arbitration allocated around 19,500 square kilometers divided it, and 6,100 square kilometer. Okay, so most of the area was with Bangladesh, and there was 6,100 kilometer square kilometer area with India. And both sides accepted the verdict, and that's how this issue was, particular issue was resolved. Okay, now let us move to another issue. So another issue, let us talk about the third issue. The third issue that is related to the islands known as New Moor Islands. New Moor Islands, okay. So I would like to show you a map to indicate where is New Moor Island. So here you guys can see India is there, and here Bangladesh is there, okay. And this is the boundary line between India and Bangladesh. And this particular place where B is mentioned, or this particular area, just in the center of the boundary, very close to the, you know, land part, very close to the boundary, just central to the boundary, is the pair of islands that is known as New Moor Islands. Okay, New Moor Islands. And this islands is a disputed part, because it lies like this is the territorial boundary, and here is the position of New Moor Islands. So the problem is that under whose territory should New Moor Island be. So this was a dispute between India and Bangladesh. So now let us see that how it went. So there was a devastating flood in around 1970 in West Bengal. Okay, in West Bengal and Bangladesh, both parts, in both places this flood happened. Okay, and it causes the emergence, because of these massive floods, there was an emergence of a new kind of island, which I just showed you the location, this particular location. Okay, there is an emergence of these islands, which are now called as New Moor Islands. Okay, and these islands are at the mouth of river Haribanga. They are at the mouth of river Haribanga. Okay, at the mouth of river Haribanga, these islands emerged. Okay, and these are known as New Moor Islands. Okay, now India called these New Moor Islands, according to India, the name of this New Moor Island was Pur Bhasha. Okay, and according to Bangladesh, the name given to these islands was South Talpati. South Talpati. Okay. Now you know, when that previously, when we discussed about that maritime dispute, okay, so this particular dispute was also taken to PCA. Okay, and our argument, India's argument, okay, so first of all I would like to tell you one thing. just look at what I'm trying to tell you right now. Okay, so say this is north, this is south. Okay, now Bangladesh is at this position, and India is here. Okay, so India is on the right hand side, okay, on the right hand side from the north, and Bangladesh is on the left hand side from the north. Okay, Bangladesh is on the left hand side. Okay, now this matter was also taken to PCA when we took the previous matter to PCA, and our argument, India's argument, was that the river Haribangas, the river Haribanga, which caused the formation, the all the sand, silt and clay, which, you know, during the floods it got deposited and formed these new more islands. So India said that this river originates from India, and all the flowings that were there is again hence could be called as originating from India, and it flows into Bay of Bengal. Okay, but you know the river Haribanga, I don't know if it would be visible in this map or not, but river Haribanga is actually the main origination is from India, but then the main channel of this river Haribanga is in Bangladesh. The main channel of Haribanga is in Bangladesh. Okay, so Bangladesh said that the main channel is in between us, only origination is from India, but the main channel is in our territory, so New Moor Island should be ours. So this was the argument from both the sides. Okay, we have our own arguments. So PCA said, what did PCA said? So the PCA said that the main channel is in east. Okay, and verdict, they said that the main channel, actually the river actually flows in both the, it's not that it the main channel, it was Bangladesh's claim that the main channel is theirs. Okay, if this is the origination, so it is flowing in India also, it is flowing in Bangladesh also. Okay, and it is originating from India only, if this is the Bangladesh. Okay, so it is flowing in India as well as in Bangladesh. And Bangladesh said that the main channel is here, but India didn't said that. India's claim would be that the main channel is in our side. When PCA look into this matter, so India won. India verdict came in favor of India that the channel, the main channel of river Haribanga, is in the east, that is in the India's part. Okay, but the issue is that these New Moor Islands, they were just created because of floods, and they couldn't be habitable, you know, population couldn't be stably living there. Okay, and also there was a recent study by a university known as Jadavpur University. So Jadavpur University study suggested that this island, these New Moor Islands, are now sinking. They are now sinking. So of course, if they would sink, then nobody's claim. If there are no islands, so no claim would be there. So that's the particular issue related to the New Moor Islands, which we just discussed. Now let us move on to the issue of another important area, that is trade. Trade is another area, and there are certain disputes in the case of trade between India and Bangladesh. So Bangladesh complained, first of all, Bangladesh complained that there is a trade deficit in Bangladesh. That means they have increased import in Bangladesh and reduced export in Bangladesh. This is the scenario of Bangladesh. Okay, and India, if we talk about the scenario of India, so our import is less and we are exporting more, so we are at a place of we are not suffering from any kind of trade deficiency, and Bangladesh is suffering from trade deficit. Okay, so this is what Bangladesh complains. So I would like to give you an example to explain this. So according to the consensus of 2019 to 2020, India's export, let me talk about India first. So India's export to Bangladesh was around 7.9, not 9, 7.6 So India's export to Bangladesh was $7.6 billion, okay, and Bangladesh, and let me talk about import also, import was, oh, okay, so let me not talk about, first of all, let me talk about the export. So Bangladesh's export was around $1.25 billion to India. So that means you guys can see the difference. If you you know, if you calculate the total, so the total you know, a trade deficit, you guys can see, okay, total was, for of course, 8.85 billion dollar trade happened, but out of that there was a trade deficit for Bangladesh of about 6.35 billion dollars. So you guys can see the level of trade deficit, it is very high. This is the trade deficit for Bangladesh, okay. So this is as an example. Also, I would like to give you the example of 2019 so you understand it even better. So in the consensus of 2019, 2018 to 2019, okay, so in that there was the India's export to Bangladesh was of about $8.6 billion, okay, $8.6 billion, and Bangladesh's export to India was only 0.873, so you guys can see billion dollar, so you guys can see 0.87, maan lo, you guys can see the amount of difference, like it is very much wide, okay. So total trade would be of around 9.43 billion dollars. Here trade is there, okay. So out of this, you guys can just calculate the trade deficiency, just minus them. So you guys can see that there is a big trade deficit for Bangladesh, okay. And for, you know, for tackling the issues and, you know, providing a kind of a solution to these issues, what India did was that we offered a duty-free access, a duty, that means we will not be having any kind of import duties, a duty-free access to Bangladeshi products, okay, except for, there is an exception, except, I mean, what am I, except for 25 items. Okay, there was a list of 25 items that were there as exceptions, okay. But Bangladesh is accusing India, like, if we have, okay, we have given them a you know, a prospect of duty free access, but Bangladesh is still accusing India of non tariff barriers. There are certain non tariff barriers which Bangladesh says that India is imposing, okay. So non tariff barriers are there. Also, there is a costly transportation, okay. So there is an issue of transportation, and according to Bangladesh, India is having a costly, India is, you know, there is a costly transportation of Bangladeshi products to India. Also, there are many of the immigration checkpoints that are offered by India which are not very operational, okay. So immigration check posts are there offered by India, but they are not very operational. Also, there is less rail connectivity. There is less of rail connectivity. I hope you have written all these points. Pause the video if you have not. And there is also a cost involved for transporting from Dhaka. Okay, so there is their capital Dhaka. If they have to export from Dhaka to Delhi, okay, so if they have to export from Dhaka to Delhi, so there is lots of transportation cost. ओके, इट इज इवन मोर कॉस्टलियर देन ढाका टू यूरोप. सो इट इज चीपर टू ट्रांसपोर्ट ढाका, यू नो, टू ढाका प्रोडक्ट्स टू यूरोप, बट इट इज कॉस्टलियर टू एक्सपोर्ट ढाका प्रोडक्ट टू दिल्ली. ओके, सो दिस इज द लाइक हाई इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कॉस्ट इज देयर. ऑल्सो ऑल्सो रिसेंटली इट वॉज सेड बाय बांग्लादेश दैट, यू नो, इट हैज बीन सेड अबाउट बांग्लादेश दैट द बांग्लादेश इज नाउ मूविंग अवे फ्रॉम द लीस्ट डेवलप्ड कंट्री टू अ डेवलपिंग कंट्री. सो दिस इज अ बिग अचीवमेंट फॉर बांग्लादेश, डेवलपिंग कंट्री. सो बांग्लादेश इज नाउ मूविंग फ्रॉम द लीस्ट डेवलप्ड कंट्री टू द डेवलपिंग कंट्री. ओके, सो इट हैज बीन प्रिडिक्टेड दैट टिल अराउंड 2026 इट वुड कम्प्लीटली रीच द स्टेटस ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्री. सो बांग्लादेश इज नाउ एज इट्स इकोनॉमी इज फ्लरिशिंग, सो बांग्लादेश इज नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव इकोनॉमिक पार्टनरशिप एग्रीमेंट. ओके, सीईपी एग्रीमेंट, कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव इकोनॉमिक पार्टनरशिप एग्रीमेंट विद इंडिया, सीईपीए आप लिखो, ठीक है, सीईपीए एग्रीमेंट इन इंडिया वेयर बाय बांग्लादेश एंड इंडिया कैन नेगोशिएट ऑन द ड्यूटीज. ओके, लाइक ऑल दोज ड्यूटीज दैट आर इम्पोज, सो देयर कुड बी अ नेगोशिएशन रिलेटेड टू दैट एंड वी वुड हैव अ मोर फ्री ट्रेड एग्रीमेंट, सो टू से. इट इंक्लूड्स द गुड्स, सर्विसेज, इन्वेस्टमेंट, ई कॉमर्स, इंश्योरेंस, IPRs, etc. Okay, and Bangladesh is looking forward to this agreement. Okay, also for Bangladesh, India is the second largest trade partner. Second largest trade partner for Bangladesh, of course, after China. China is the first one. Okay, so India is the second largest trade partner, so they would like to have good trade associations with us. So this was something about the relation of Bangladesh and India in terms of trade. Okay, so I would like to touch upon a question here. Question is that is Bangladesh moving closer towards China? Okay, so this is a question, that is Bangladesh moving closer to China? Okay, and what is the expense of this relation, you know, expense of the India-Bangladesh relation, what is the expenses involved here after this closeness? Okay, so let me share with you certain instances where China tried to develop good relationships with Bangladesh. Of course, their economy is growing and also it shares border with India. So strategically as well as, you know, it would be a strategic as well as a from the military perspective also. Bangladesh's close relations strategically with China is of great importance. So, in around 2020, there has been the apprehensions from many of the newspaper experts in India that Bangladesh is growing closer relations with China. Okay. So, recently also, China offered a duty-free. China offered a duty-free access to Bangladesh for their products. Okay, and in 2016, I'm just sharing with you the instances where it shows that yeah, China and Bangladesh's relationship is improving. So in around 2016, Xi Jinping visited the capital of Bangladesh, Dhaka. Xi Jinping visited Dhaka. Okay, and he offered a project of $24 billion investment in Bangladesh. He proposed this project for 20 in total 27 projects of around $24 billion. So you can see it is a big project. Also recently, very recently, in April 2020, there is a $250 million project, $250 million project on the construction of an airport. $250 billion project construction of airport in the northeastern Bangladesh, and the place exactly is Sylhet. In northeastern Bangladesh, there is a place called Sylhet, and this project of airport construction is in Sylhet, and it is a $250 million project. So for this project, both China and India, both of us are bidding for this project, but China won, India lost. Okay, we lost this deal. Also, if I am speaking in the terms of domestic affairs, which impacted our relationship with Bangladesh, so there was a recent issue of CAANRC. So CAA. So somewhere there, it talked about the illegal migrants of Bangladesh. Okay, illegal migrants which came during the wartime period, when the military coup happened. So there are illegal migrant issue related to CAA, which created ill will in Bangladesh. So these are the certain issues which makes us rethink our relations with Bangladesh, and as it happened with Nepal, that Nepal now grew very closer to China, so we should not lose upon Bangladesh in the same way. But somewhere Bangladesh already know, I told you that Sheikh Hasina feel obliged towards India, and she feel grateful, not as an obligation, but she feels grateful that India helped her during the time of the assassination of Sheikh Abdullah, his father. So she somewhere have that, and right now Awami League is in the leadership there. So of course our relationships are very nice, and she knows about this China, and China basically, and she's not going to go that easily towards their side, of course, but still we need to rethink upon our relation, and we should try to solve the remaining issues that are still there, and we should improve our friendship even more with Bangladesh. So this was all about India and Bangladesh relations. I hope you completely understood this topic. There is nothing much typical to worry about. Okay, so before leaving this, before concluding this topic, there is another single topic that I would like to take, another last topic that is left, which I would like to talk about. PM Modi's visit in March 2021, very recently, to Bangladesh. Okay, his visit. So it has been from 26th to 27th March 2021 was his visit to Bangladesh. So it was a golden jubilee. The event was of golden jubilee of Bangladesh's independence, and also it was birth centenary of Sheikh Abdullah. So both events were there. So India was invited because India had a big hand in Bangladesh's freedom. Okay, so we are also Bangladesh is also constructing a memorial is being constructed by Bangladesh, okay, for Indian martyrs. For Indian martyrs, okay, at a place called as Ashuganj is the name of the place, and this Ashuganj is in Brahman Baria is the name of the place where A okay, where this Ashuganj is placed. Okay, so PM also visited two temples in Bangladesh, and three hearts were also inaugurated. Okay, and another important thing is a new train project, a train project called Mithali Express. There is an inauguration of a new train project called Mithali Express, which would be from Dhaka to New Jalpaiguri. New Jalpaiguri. So there are certain issues like Teesta water sharing treaty, which we are not still able to, you know, finalize, and but we in total we have good relations, okay, and Awami League understands the primacy of India in the external relations. So we are looking forward to many another important object that we are looking forward to, and India is also showing India's project is this, and Bangladesh is showing interest in it. So it is a trilateral highway project which is from Kolkata to Dhaka to northeastern, that is Manipur and then to Myanmar. Okay, and in the last it is Manisot in Thailand. I'm writing it here, okay, it is to Manisot in Thailand. So India, Bangladesh and Thailand. So this is our project, a trilateral highway project, also relating to SEPA, which I talked about. We are looking forward to that also. So this was all related to the issue of India and Bangladesh. We have completed this bilateral relation, and I hope you liked and enjoyed this and understood it. And if you liked it, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. And this is it. In the next video, we'll be talking about Nepal-India relationships. Okay, so till then, stay tuned and stay safe. Bye bye.